guys, and welcome back to Dog Coffee and Guitars, episode 14. I got my business associate, Slug, here with me. We're very excited for today's lesson because we are going to video game world. That's right. Look, we're going to treat our guitar practice like it's a video game. What do I mean by that? Well, look, the games that always got me as a kid to play for hours and hours and hours were the games in which you set high scores. I mean, whether it was Pac-Man or Asteroids or Guitar Hero, setting a high score and being competitive about kept me doing it over and over and over again. So we are going to take a competitive approach to our guitar practice this week. But before we do, it's a very, very special week because it's National Coffee Week. National Coffee Week, and I would be remiss if I didn't do a special coffee edition of Dog Coffee and Guitars. I'll be honest, this is what I do for a living. I teach guitar. Sometimes for 8 hours a day, I'm in front of a screen teaching kids how to play guitar, and these kids have a lot of energy. I've got to match that energy, so coffee is my life force. Slug, he has energy without it. I look up to this guy. But Slug, I think we should do some coffee reviews. We're going to do some coffee reviews first, and then we're going to video game world, and we're going to learn some great exercises, and I promise I'll show you how to play that Mario theme song that I was playing in the beginning. The first review today we're doing is going to be a local place. I've passed by this place a million times and never walked in because I've got to pass about 6 coffee shops on 3rd Street in Philadelphia just to get to this place. But right off of 3rd and Market, there is a gem. I will no longer be passing it up anymore. Check this out, guys. Old City Coffee. Old City Coffee right off of 3rd and Market. They are incredibly nice in there. The place smells amazing. I bought a pound of their dark roast. And I'm not very often blown away by a cup of coffee, but this stuff is amazing. They use completely recyclable bags, the whole deal. They will ship nationwide. I have a cup of it here. Guys, it's incredibly smooth. It's good stuff. I mean, it smells amazing. I will drink this every single day. And I don't throw this score around often. In fact, only one other coffee has ever gotten this score, and it is my beloved Wawa Dark Roast. But Wawa Dark Roast now has company. Old City Coffee, 3rd and Market, their Dark Roast is going to get an 11 out of 10 on our Dog Coffee and Guitar scores. It's that good. I don't care where you are in the country. Go on oldcitycoffee.com. Buy some of this stuff. This is good. This is good. And I'm not just saying it. This is good stuff. 11 out of 10. Now we have one more. Slug, what do you think? Should we tell them about the Mint Invaders? Yeah. All right, we're gonna tell them about the Mint Invaders. I was scrolling through Facebook when I get an ad, and it said, "Do you drink your coffee black?" And you know how we do it around here: no sugar, no cream, nothing but caffeine. Do you drink your coffee black? I said yes. It's, do you love mint chocolate chip ice cream? Of course. Are you still wearing the same 3/4 sleeve Chase Utley T-shirt that you had in the 7th grade? And I said, these are getting oddly specific now. I have to buy this. Bones Coffee Company. Bones Coffee Company has come out with the Mint Invaders from Chocolate Space. I'm not a big flavored coffee guy. I like my coffee to taste like coffee, but I love mint chocolate chip. And I mean, there's aliens on the cover. And I was like, all right. Take my $14.99. Let me see what this is all about. I had some of this the other day. I mean, there's people running out of an ice cream shop. The whole deal. I had some of this the other day, and it's delicious. It's not overly minty. It's a hint of mint, hint of chocolate. It's good coffee. It's good stuff. It smells great. The cover is cool. Slug, what do you think? Now, in the flavored coffee world, I would give this a 10. As far as flavored coffees go, this is great. I'm not the biggest flavored coffee guy. If I have to stack it up against the Wawa Dark Roast and the everyday coffee drinkers, I'd give it an 8. This is still a great coffee. You could drink this every day. If you like flavored coffee, you could drink this every day. Guys, Bones Coffee Company, Mint Invaders from Chocolate Space, that's got an 8. Let's get to it. What? Slug, I think we angered the Mint Invaders. And they like Coheed.
Oh no.
Oh no, where are we going here? Dude, I don't think we're in Philly anymore. No. There's like some type of floating logo depicting a website where you can learn any instrument for just $40 over Zoom, Skype, or FaceTime. There's floating words coming out of nowhere. Where are we? We seriously messed up. We upset the Mint Invaders. You're gonna have to go scavenge for supplies. Go get some snacks, some fruit roll-ups. If anybody can find it, it's you, buddy. Go ahead. We gotta set some high scores around here. Go ahead. Go. Oh, and Slug, if Pac-Man gives you one of those cherries, don't eat those. Those aren't for dogs. Okay. All right, guys. We got to set some high scores. If we don't, we're not going to get out of here. Slug's going to have to panhandle and bribe somebody to get us back to Philly. So let's skip all that and let's put some work in, guys. Like I said earlier in the video, if you want to see big time leaps of improvement in your practice, be competitive about it. I don't know about you, but competition brings the best out in me, whether sports, video games, and especially music. When I was growing up, all my friends played music and we competed against each other. We wanted to learn a song that somebody else couldn't. And you know, if I learned a song that Julian couldn't play, or Julian learned a song that Adam couldn't play, I mean, it was something that we had over the other person, and that drove us all forward. Me particularly, it really drove me forward. I wanted to win. So we're going to win the game. We're going to set some new high scores. I'm going to show you some exercises along the way. So this first one, you don't even need your left hand. This one's going to go out to Steve Harrison. He's part of this great group on Facebook that I was invited to join a little while ago. Shout out to the G Stringers family, Guitar Corner. You guys are great. It's the most supportive group of guitar players on the internet, and there is not a close second. Everybody, Steve and Mike and Neil and Duska and everybody, if I forget, Dwayne, all you guys, cool people, good musicians. Steve asked me about a string skipping exercise. We're going to start with a string skipping exercise. We want to start all of our exercises at a comfortable tempo. So don't right off the bat try to find the fastest way you can do these things, the fastest tempo you can do these at. Find something, you know, moderate tempo. I like 95 beats per minute, moderato. You start slower, work your way up. Track your progress every step of the way. It really helps. I tell all of my students to do this. I tell all of my students to do this. Maybe 10% listen. Those are the 10% that really, really excel at the instrument. So let's do this, guys. Set your metronomes, like I said, wherever you're comfortable, and track your progress along the way. Here's the exercise. You can do this while you watch TV, by the way. You don't need your left hand. You just need your guitar pick and your picking hand. Sit this in the lap, watch Breaking Bad on Netflix for like the 8,000th time, and get this done. Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna pick the E string twice. Start with eighth notes and then gradually work your way up to 16th notes. We're gonna pick the E string, down pick, up pick. And then to the G. So we're gonna go now to the B string. To the D. So you're picking up a pattern. We're gonna go E, G, B, D, G, A, D, E. And then in reverse. E, D, A, G, D, B, G, E. All right, there's a string skip exercise. Nothing in my life has ever helped me with string skipping more than that one. And like I said, do it while you watch TV so you're distracted. If you really want to learn to string skip, it's got to be something automatic. So train yourself to do it automatically. Train yourself to do it while you're not looking at your hands, so that your guitar pick, you want this thing, I know it's a piece of nylon or plastic depending on what material you use, but you really want it to feel like it has nerve endings, like it's a part of your hand. So in order to do that, take your eyes off of it and run that exercise. So there is the string skipping exercise. Now, we're gonna get to threes, fours, and fives, and even sixes. So let's do this. In the beginning of the episode, you saw me play the Mario thing. I was playing this lit. The first time I ever heard anything like this, it was honestly from the Kiss record. Listen to Love Gun in Kiss. And it's actually Paul Stanley that plays it. He starts playing ascending pentatonic triplets like this. You know, with the gain and the fire and everything else like that. I was playing it, of course, in the key that we were playing in A minor. I'm going to show you guys ascending and descending pentatonic triplets, three notes per click. Try to, like I said, start at a moderate tempo and keep bumping that up faster and faster and faster until you find your high score. We're going to go like this. So we have 8th fret of the E string on a down pick, the 5th fret of the E on an up pick, and then the 8th fret of the B. So we're running backwards. We're going to play three notes of the pentatonic scale. Now, the pattern is every time we play a new set of triplets, one new note from the scale gets added in. Look, so that was 8, 5, 8, right? We have C, A, and G. Then we're gonna start the next pattern on the A note, then the G, then the E. So that's 5E, 8B, and 5B. And if the whole scale trips you up at first, just break it into smaller chunks. Try two groups of three. Now, if we go, we wanna add another one, we'll go 8, 5 on the B, and then 7G. Try to hear that going on in your head. Three notes per click. Now, if you know your pentatonic scale, you should be able to figure the rest of the pattern out. So I'll kind of move a little quicker here. 5, 7, 5. 5B, 7G to 5Gs. Now 7, 5G to 7D. Then we have 5G, 7D, and 5D. Then we're gonna go 7, 5, and then 7A, 5D, 7A, 5A, 7, 5, 8, and then 5, 8, 5. Ascending is the same thing in reverse. I will post tabs for these exercises as well. Look for the tabs in the comment section. Look for tabs in the description of the video. Look for tabs in the description of the video. I'll post them up there. I'm happy. So we have threes. And like I said, I'm going to post the tabs, but use your brain. Use your brain. Figure out the patterns. Try not to rely on the tabs. Use the tabs as like a crutch, but use your ears and use your knowledge of your scales and patterns to bring you through. You're playing three notes. Imagine it's like the first note, second, third, and then second, third, fourth, fourth, fifth, sixth, so on and so forth. All right, now fours. Let's kind of move a little quicker here. If you're going to take the same scale and do it in fours, we're going to play 16th notes. You could also make this into 8th notes at first and bump your way up to 16th notes. If you're doing 8th notes, you're going to get something like this. And 16th notes. So, we're going to play four notes from the scale. 8, 5, 8, 5, which is the SpongeBob theme song, now that I think about it. Anyways, 8, 5, 8, 5, and then we're going to play that, repeat the 8, 5 on the B to 7, 5 on the G. Now, 8, 5, 7, 5, 7, 5, 7, 5, 7, 5, 7, 5, 7, 5, 8, 5, and then to our octave. So practice threes and fours. Now, fives, we start to really start to move, and I want you to track your progress. You should make a chart for yourself. How fast can I play three notes per click? How fast can I play four notes per click? How fast can I play five notes per click? And how fast can I play six? Set high scores. That's gonna be motivation. Anybody that tells you to play for 2 hours or 8 hours or 30 minutes or whatever, if you set a timer for yourself, it feels like work, right? Think about work, think about school, whether you're in school or in your work. The clock is what makes it boring. You are looking up at the clock and you are going, two more hours and I'm out of here. Whereas if you could leave work when you have done a good job, or if you could just leave school when your work was done, I think we would enjoy the work a whole lot more. Think about that for a second. Now, let's set this world on fire with our five notes per click. Here's the exercise, and we'll stick with the pentatonic idea, and let's move to E minor, so we have a little more room here. We'll use an E minor pentatonic, and I'm gonna bring you guys from a high G note to the open E, like this, slowly. Let's do it, guys. We're gonna be picking the first four notes and sliding into the fifth. That's gonna be, for the most part, the pattern here. We're gonna go 15-12 on the E string, 15-12 on the B, and then slide to the 10th fret. Then 12-10-12-9, B and G, 12-10-12-9. It's also very instructive to show you your different positions of the E minor pentatonic scale. And then slide into our 7th fret. So we go 12-10-12-9-7, 9-7-9-7-5, 7-5-7-5-7. And then on the A string, 7-5-7-5-3. And then open, look at that. That whole chunk of a fretboard. Always alternate pick too. So there's threes, fours, and fives. Let's play a little bit of legato. Let's give our picking hand a rest. And I'm gonna give you guys an exercise that'll be six notes per click. I've been doing this one since I was probably about 13 years old. I got this from a Guitar World magazine that had Randy Rhoads exercises on it. It was like the lost exercises of Randy Rhoads. And I was like, oh my God, take my $10. So Guitar World magazine, if you're too young to know, back in the day, we would like read magazines. There would be like words on paper with no screen, and they would have like helpful guitar stuff and like a CD-ROM with like our favorite guitar players talking about stuff on them before YouTube existed. It was a cool time. So there was a like this lost Randy Rhoads treasure trove of exercises. I don't remember any of them except for this one, so this one must have been the one that stuck the best. This was the exercise. I do this to this day, and it had on the issue, it said, hey, he did these at 96 beats per minute, so right around that moderate tempo that we're talking about. The exercise sounds like this. We're gonna go first finger, middle finger, pinky finger, all hammer-ons, six notes per click. I'm going 2-3-5, 2-3-5, 2-3-5, E-A-D. Now we're gonna shift up. 4, 5, and 7 on the D string. So we have 2-3-5, 2-3-5, 2-3-5, 4-5-7, hop up to the A. 4-5-7, back to the D. To the G. 6-7-9 on the G string, come up to 6-7-9 on the D, back to 6-7-9 on the G, 7-8-10 on the B, 7-8-10 on the E, back to E, and I like to throw an E minor 7 chord at the end of that to make it fancy, 7-9-7-8, play a bar chord there. So, you get this. There's your Randy Rhoads six notes per click exercise. Guys, these just give you some ideas. But take the overarching theme here of tracking our progress, tracking our high scores. Apply it to exercises. You don't have to listen to me. Apply it to exercises that you already do. Apply it to what you already normally play. Get the most out of your practice time. So you get two that are legato exercises at six notes per click. You have one that's five notes per click. I gave you a pentatonic at four notes per click, and then your triplets ascending and descending at three. So start at your threes, work your way up, track your progress. I'd love to know how you guys are doing. I will show you, as promised, the Mario theme song up in the octave that I played it in. We're in the 12th position here. We're gonna play the 13th fret of the B string to the 12 to the 14. It's a little C major arpeggio. Roll your finger down, we're gonna get 14 G and then the 12 B. So it's now 15, 14 on the G. So it's now up here. I in the beginning of the video, I did a little sweep, a little triad arpeggio, A minor, 14, 13, 12. And then that'll lead us to our E note. And then you're gonna play a G and an A, the 15th fret to the 17th fret. Now we're gonna go like this. And then after that, we're gonna play F, G, E. So we got, and then C, D, B. So 13, 15, 12 on the E and on the B. Now we're gonna, this little chromatic part is very cool. 15, 14, 13 on our E string, 16 B, and then 12 E. So you get. And then 14 G, 13 B, 15 B. And then you're gonna repeat that. We're gonna play the chromatic run again and slide all the way up to the 20th fret. Hit that 1, 2, 3. We're gonna play the chromatic run again. Not like that, we'll play the chromatic run again. Play the run again and follow it with a 16, 15, 13 on the B, and you have the Mario theme song, guys. Thanks for watching.
Wait, what happened? Oh, Independence Hall. So I think we did it. We're back in Philly, buddy. We're back in Philly. I hope you didn't eat any of those cherries. We're all right, guys. Hope you enjoyed the lesson. Taking that competitive approach to guitar, I'm happy to be back in Philly. The only bad things that happen in Philly involve our sports teams. Slug, it's been a long day, man. Let's go to Nick's and get a roast pork. Let's go. Remember, guys, free lessons for animal donations. Thanks for watching. Love you guys. See you next time. Don't call me guitars.